Hi, and welcome back. In case you're new here, my name's Samuel, and on this channel I do stuff like library reviews and talk about cinematic composing and music production in general. And today I'm starting a series. It's going to be a small series of four, maybe five videos where I want to really take an in-depth look into the BBC Symphony Orchestra Core that I own. And I've been using it a lot. It's a real workhorse of mine. It's in almost every project, there is at least a part of it. I came to, well, love and hate it. We have a complicated relationship. I really love it. I think it's a great product at a very competitive price point, particularly if you wait for something like Black Friday sale, summer sale, winter sale. Yeah, I mean, I'm not like the biggest expert, but I think after using it quite a lot, I found some of its strengths and also some of its weaknesses that you should be aware of, and also some ways to work around of that. Look, you can see I have something prepared here, which is like a full piece that uses lots of articulations and different sounds from the string libraries. And we're going to go through that, I promise. But before we do that, let's have a brief overview of the user interface, because I think that might also be very interesting. So this is how BBCSO boots up. And let's go quickly from top to bottom. We have a set of pretty generic and general information like CPU usage, memory, things like that. What may come in handy is the MIDI channels. You can tune it, pan it, set the volume. That's what I usually use faders for. And then you have, this is actually quite interesting. So if we switch to a short articulation such as spiccato, my suggestion is that you just really play around with your keyboard and you figure out what works best for you and your MIDI controller, because every MIDI controller and every playing style is a little bit different, and you should adjust it to your own playing style. Now, from here, one thing that's interesting in this settings page, or two things that I like to highlight, obviously there's a lot of stuff in there, but what is really helpful is that in the general tab, you have this copy button, which I'm not gonna hit, because what it does is it takes all the settings from this specific instance of the BBCSO plugin and applies it to all the instances. Now, I have already all of the other tracks set up the way I want, so I'm not going to click that. In the interface section, one thing that I highly recommend is the disable auto hide knob parameter pop-up, which in my case is default on disabled. So what that does is when you click on this knob and you then focus something else, otherwise the effects that you can trigger would go away and you don't have them in your field of view anymore. And I like to see what I'm doing. Now, here you have, let's switch to the legato patch. You have expression and dynamics. So expression is CC11, which is basically acting as a volume. Just blunt volume. And then we have dynamics, which helps you shift between the three dynamic layers that you have in the string sections. And go from piano to forte. I highly suggest, so that's something I do generally, to use both in conjunction to get the tone that you want. It just gives you one additional layer to express yourself and make your music really expressive. By the way, if there's anything useful in this video, it would be great if you could leave a like. It's free for you and it means a lot to me. Let's continue. Other than that, down here you have all of the different articulations. You can select and choose how you're going to trigger the articulations. You can also trigger your articulations in different ways, like you can assign it to CC controllers, MIDI channels, lots of stuff you can do there, but I don't want to go into details. Now, another thing you have is you have the effects section, which in my humble opinion is not really useful, because you'll basically just see all of the stuff that you have already up there assigned to this huge circular knob, so you have the exact same options in a different place. If that's what you prefer, just go for that. So let's go through the articulations. What is really, really charming is they're exactly the same for all of the instruments of your string section. So from violins one all the way down to the basses, you will find the exact same articulations, and they will be also configured to the exact same key switch. I think that's really comfortable. So there's basically two ways to trigger the legato. One of them is by having note overlap. So if you watch me play now, I hope that was clearly visible. If I push a note while another one is pressed, you'll trigger the legato up. The other option that you have is using the sustain pedal. You cannot see that now. I'm just pushing the sustain pedal now. So that works as well. I usually prefer programming my MIDI using the overlap of notes. That's how I usually do it and how we'll see in this piece. I would like to show you two things that you should know about the legatos. Yeah, let's do that. Let's loop this section and let me show you what I mean. So here we have a typical fingered transition. So from up to down, we will have a fingered transition. Nice. If we lower the velocity of the target note that we're going to be ending up in, then what you get is you get a portamento. Let's see if you can spot the difference. So there you clearly had a much, much stronger sliding motion than with the fingered legato in between. So that's something to be aware of. You have different types of legatos, and what bothers me about the legato patch is particularly in the higher ranges of the instrument, particularly in the violins. Violas also have this problem. When you start a note and it has a very high velocity, you'll have a very harsh attack. So there was a bit of leaning. Now let me up the velocity. Did you hear that? I don't like that. And there's two reasons why I don't like it. First of all, I don't like the sound of it. I don't understand why they made it so harsh. And the second reason is, if I wanna really have a marcato at the beginning of a note, you have an actual articulation for that purpose. And why not use that one instead of putting that on the legato patch? What is though really useful about the legato patch, and let me check if you can see that. If I play really short notes, the legato patch will actually output also very nice and gentle notes. And I like the sound a lot, so much that sometimes it gives me an additional option to playing staccatos, just playing short legato notes. Legato have a vibrato option, which will make it sound quite a bit different. So this is with full vibrato and this without vibrato. And you basically have an on-off switch with a bit of a crossfade. It's basically off and on. So there's no different layers between the vibrato. You cannot, you know, transition from a little bit of vibrato to molto vibrato. It will basically be a crossfade between two samples. Then you have classic longs, which again have this vibrato option, and they have a release option. If I turn this all the way up when I let go of the note, now you'll hear that there is a much longer release tail. If I cut this down, it will sound very artificial. See, by default, it's somewhere in the middle. Then we have concertino sound. We have the flautandos, which are really, really charming, particularly in the softer layers, like. Very beautiful sound, I love those. Then we have spiccatos, great for ostinatos and things like that. We have staccatos, which are also very short notes, but they have a little bit more body. We're gonna see later how I use them to create more movement and realism in a melody. Pizzicatos, which are very, very nice. Although, let's switch to the double basses, because honestly, this is my favorite instrument in the string section. to use the pizzicato on. Oh, this is such a beautiful sound. I love the pizzicatos on the basses. We have collegno. Also very nice for effects. Tremolos. Tremolos are really cool also if you want to build tension. Again, my only complaint here is you cannot vary the speed of the tremolo, and the tremolo is not very consistent. Remember that sound. Now let's just go to violins too. It's literally the same instrument, the same ranges, just two players less. And you somehow get a different sound. Also the speed of the tremolo to me sounds different, but maybe I'm just making this up. Then we have trills in major, minor. We have longs in different places played on the instrument. So this is soltasto, which will give it a much warmer body. We have harmonics, also really great for tension moments. We have short harmonics, which is I think it's really cool to have them. Batok pizzicatos, I think also most effective if you put them, for instance, on celli. But then we also have to select the batok pizzicatos, so let's go there. Really cool sound, and really cool effects with that. The marcato attack, I already showed you, it's basically a long note, but it has an accent at the beginning of the note. And then, very beautiful tremolo sul ponte. Let's make this a bit softer. Really cool sound. And also with concertino. And then we also have a long sul ponte. Very edgy sound, kind of basically the opposite of the long soltasto. And finally, we also have the spiccatos with concertino. Really cool sound as well. So you get really a whole lot of articulations, and that I think is a great thing. And what I find to be really astonishing is that you get them all throughout all of the instruments of your string section. So you even have things like short harmonics on the double basses. What an interesting sound. Don't think I've ever heard that played live. It's really cool. Yeah, that's basically the interface. And now what I would like to do is I would like to remove this little piece here. And you will see me from the past talk about this piece, which you probably have been waiting for to hear and listen to, which is a piece from my submission to the Indie Film Composing Music Competition. Don't remember what it is. IFMC. So, this year, and you'll find the video here linked if you want to watch the full IFMC video and how that fits the picture. But for this video now, to see the sound of the string section of the BBC orchestra, we're going to focus on two little pieces which I cut together here. So let's listen to me from the past. Let's have a quick listen so that you get an impression what it's about. If you're enjoying the content of this video and it's interesting to you, please consider subscribing to the channel and also hitting the bell notification. I have more episodes like this one coming up on woodwinds, brass, and percussion to showcase all of the BBC Symphony Orchestra Core that I own in this style. So if you like this, remember to subscribe. Let's move on. Okay, so why did I pick that one? Because in this piece, I actually played around a lot with different articulations. So I thought it would be a good showcase to show you the kind of things I do. For instance, here we have this melody. Just let me sing aloud. The violins ones are basically playing the melody of the piece in spiccatos most of the time. But sometimes I throw in a staccato. So that's a thing to notice, that the staccato has a bit more body. So when the melody goes dum 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 da da dum dum da da dum da dum dum, I really wanted these two notes to be a little bit more emphasized, so they're staccato notes, whereas the rest is spiccato. And unfortunately, the spiccato and the staccatos aren't really balanced with the velocities. So you see, although this note has an emphasis, the velocity is lower than of the next note. And yeah, that's because they're not perfectly balanced. So I end up having to play around with the velocities, but that's what it sounds like. See that this, it adds a lot to the liveliness of the music. And then here I have these two kind of little runs. And for runs, what I typically do is I double them with a legato patch. So the legato patch is then I use there, I use expression. Apparently I didn't use it in this case, but modulation particularly. So I have the dynamics. So just the legato sounds like this, which is a bit washed out. But if you combine it with the shorts, it gives a really beautiful sound. And if I don't throw in the legatos in there, which they aren't very loud, it's a bit more aggressive than I want it to sound in the overall scheme of things, if that makes sense with the melody. And then, yeah, the same principle kind of repeats. We have again the melody in here. We have again those two runs, which are layered with legatos. And then something interesting happened here. These notes are grayed out because I muted them. Because for whatever reason, in this specific spot, the just playing short notes on the legato patch, so those are four short notes on the legato patch, it sounded nicer for this da 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 than the spiccato was too aggressive, the staccato also was not very perfect, and I ended up using just short notes of the legato patch. And then we have again towards the end, we have another one of those runs. And let's talk about the second section a bit later. But what's important is when the melody comes up here, let me layer these three things together. And we have a look here. So what happens here is we end up on a trill. So let's have a listen just to the violins here. And there's not only the trill going on, but there's in these longs too, I have a moccato, and the moccato combined with the trill gives me a nice attack and the trill. And now as the second part starts, violins one and violins two end up playing in octaves, which is something that's very stereotypical for a melody line to be carried by the violin section. And you can see that I here actually use the different kind of legato transitions that there are. For instance, this here is a portamento, which gives it this boom. I liked it there as part of the melody. I think that's the only, like, it happens once there. Oh no, there is another portamento at the very beginning. And look, here we have this problem, which I apparently didn't remove because probably in the full mix I didn't even notice. But if you just listen to the violins, like this note in the, I believe that's the violins too, is really, it has a gross attack. I don't know how you feel about that, but I feel like I want to soften this. Yeah, much better. So that's what I meant, that I end up mingling around with the velocities in the legatos when phrases start. And yeah, all of that is introduced with a run, and I do hear what I typically do on runs. I have a legato patch where I kind of raise the velocity up to the point, like I lean into the run, and I double this with shorts where I use spiccatos, and obviously for the shorts it's the velocities, and you can see they're not that loud, but they add a lot of definition to the sound, so it's important that they're there. Celli are joining in also on the melody, so if I add the celli here, I think they're doubling the violins, so single out the celli. They're playing pretty high. Yeah, so that's basically it for today. I mean, what's my takeaway? I think the strings are really, really nice. The legatos, sometimes I really struggle with them. I wish they were a bit more playable. But if I then first play in my lines and then move in and start tuning it, I always end up having a sound that I really like. Generally, the string section lacks a bit of aggression on the louder end. On the other hand, the softer sounds are really, really nice. And you get a load of articulations. The plugin is great. It's really, really cool. I have like many, many instances of the BBC plugin in my template. And even when I open loads of tracks, it's really, really light, really fast, and very comfortable to use. You have only 3 dynamic layers. It's a bit limiting, as I already mentioned, particularly on the louder end. On the other hand, you have everything you need. It's the full orchestra. So I guess that's kind of the trade-off you make. And obviously the big difference between the Core and the professional version is that in the Core version, you only get 1 premix microphone position. I hope that you enjoyed this type of video and that it was useful to you. The next one I'm doing is on the woodwind section. And that one's really cool because we're also going to talk about the solo instruments that come in there that I find particularly beautiful. So I hope you tune in for the next episode and keep creating.